Hi, I'm Kate, the Simple Biologist, and today we're going to be talking about a paper that was published by researchers from the University of Pennsylvania. And what they're looking at is using immune therapy to try to cure autoimmune diseases. Generally, when we get sick, it's from outside invaders, like bacteria or viruses. But what happens when the thing making you sick is yourself? This is what happens in autoimmune diseases. And the autoimmune disease that these researchers chose to focus on is one called Pemphigus Vulgaris, or PV for short. PV is an autoimmune disease that affects the skin. It happens when the immune system recognizes the skin and attacks it, causing lots of inflammation and cell death. This leads to people with PV having huge skin blisters. It's kind of like having burns all over your body. The paper we're going to talk about today outlines a possible treatment where they fight fire with fire. Or in this case, they fight the disease-causing immune cell with more immune cells. Because if you can get rid of the disease-causing immune cell, you can cure PV. In order to understand how more immune cells can solve the problem, we need to understand what's really going on in PV. PV starts with an immune cell called a B cell. B cells are usually responsible for recognizing outside invaders, like virus or bacteria. But in the case of PV, instead of recognizing an outside invader, these B cells develop the ability to recognize a completely normal skin protein. It's kind of like if you got amnesia and forgot your best friend. So people with PV are continually making these B cells that are attacking their skin. And if their bodies are constantly making them, then how do we stop them? This paper uses an idea that was thought of before, and that idea is to engineer a killer T cell. Killer T cells are part of your immune system, and what they do is they recognize things and kill them. It's kind of like having your own personal robot that can recognize people in a red shirt and then zap them. So if you can have one of these killer T cells recognize and kill the disease-causing B cells, you can stop the disease. But how do you make these killer T cells recognize these disease-causing B cells? What this lab did was create a killer T cell that's kind of like a wolf in sheep's clothing. Instead of having a recognition site on the outside, it instead shows a piece of the normal skin protein on its surface, the same skin protein that the B cells usually recognize. So now the B cells will recognize the killer T cell all on its own. And when the B cell recognizes the T cell and they come together, the killer T cell will kill the disease-causing B cell. Right now, these researchers have been able to test their killer T cell on cells in a dish, and also in mice that have been engineered to have PV. And both of those results turned out really good. The killer T cells only kill the disease-causing B cells, and they don't kill any of the normal cells either in the mouse or in the dish. It turns out that creating this immune therapy where you engineer killer T cells also has another benefit. So these disease-causing B cells actually have two choices. They can either recognize the killer T cells and die, or they can try to change themselves, such that they don't come into contact with the killer T cells anymore. And if they change themselves away from recognizing the killer T cells, they can't recognize the skin either. So whether the disease-causing B cells are killed by the killer T cells, or whether they just mutate away to avoid recognizing the killer T cells, both of those things end up curing the disease. Overall, this is a super cool idea, and it's got a lot of initial promise. But right now, it's not done yet. The next steps are to try this therapy in humans, and make sure that it's exactly the same as it is in mice. They also need to work on how they're going to deliver these engineered killer T cells into the person. But once they can figure these out, they can start testing and reversing this immune disease, and maybe even apply this idea to other autoimmune diseases out there besides just PV. I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe to my channel for more science videos, or follow me on Twitter or Instagram for more science updates. See you next time.